All right, let's learn how to use Gale eBooks for your background research. To get started, go to elac.edu and click on the library link at the top. Or you can go directly to our library homepage by typing in elac.edu/library into your browser. Scroll down, and underneath the one search box, look for the A to Z databases link. Click on that link to open up our A to Z list of databases. To find Gale eBooks, click on the G for Gale and scroll down until you see the Gale eBooks link. Go ahead and click on that link. Okay, so now we're here at Gale eBooks. This is a great place to start your research. It's full of encyclopedias with subject-specific reference articles. So you can either search for a topic using the search bar at the top, or you can browse the eBooks by discipline. So for example, if you're interested in medicine, looks like we have 146 encyclopedias that you can browse through. So let's say, for example, I want to look in this obesity in childhood and adolescence eBook. I can click on the cover. And it will load the table of contents below. So here you can feel free to click on some of these subheadings and they'll take you to the articles within that ebook. And you can see here that we're looking at a topic overview, the title of which is Epidemiology of Childhood Obesity. It's coming from volume one of the ebook that we clicked on, Obesity in Childhood and Adolescence. You have the authors of the article here, the editors of the encyclopedia, and the date of publication. So as you scroll down, you can now read your reference article. Usually these reference articles are split into helpful subheadings that make for a quick and easy read. And at the very top, we have translate options, font size options, and you can even have this article read to you using this listen feature. All the way at the top, you'll also notice whenever you click on the title of one of these entries, you'll have a cite option, an email option, download, print, and you can generate a link back to this article. I'll quickly show you the cite option. That's just these quotes here. When you click on that button, it will auto-generate a citation for the entry. So you can see it defaults to MLA citation style, but you can also switch over to APA. Depending on which style your professor prefers. And then you can copy and paste that into your references or works cited page. If you have a topic that you'd like to look up, you can also use the search bar at the top, and that will search through all of the eBooks instead of looking at one e-encyclopedia at one time. So let's say, for example, you are looking up information on spina bifida. You can start typing in your topic and you'll notice that you'll get suggestions. So I'm going to just click on the second one, spina bifida, a general one, and it will conduct a search. And now you can see we're getting different entries and they're coming from different encyclopedias. So this one is coming from the Encyclopedia of Neurological Disorders. This one is coming from Encyclopedia of Medicine. This one is coming from Encyclopedia of Children's Health. So for example, if you are looking at this particular topic and you want to know more about how it affects children, this particular encyclopedia might be your best bet. So at this point, if you want to read this article, you would click on the title. So the title is the larger font. If you were to click on the encyclopedia title, you'll just be taken to the table of contents. So you do want to click on the title. Okay, so again, when you click on the title, you get all of the source information right below the title of the article. And in this case, we have a disease or disorder overview. It's coming from the Gale Encyclopedia of Children's Health, Volume 4. We have our authors listed here, as well as the encyclopedia editor and the date of publication. Scrolling down, now you'll see you have all of this helpful information broken up into subheadings. So you'll have a description, you'll often have some images, risk factors, so on and so forth. And again, at the very top, if you think this article will be helpful in your research and you may use it as support in your essay or assignment, you can grab your citation at the top. I'll click the cite button one more time. Remember, it defaults to MLA. If you need APA or Chicago, you can click on those. But here is your MLA citation for this particular entry. One last thing I want to remind you, make sure when you copy and paste your citation that your italics come over in your Microsoft Word or Google document. If they don't, make sure to go back and edit that. So usually your encyclopedia title needs to be italicized, and the name of the database, Gale eBooks, will also have to be italicized. That's it. Good luck on your research.